Let us solve one more problem, problem number 9. This is on I section. You have four sections, T, I, L and channel. Now, the problem goes like this, problem number 9. An I section consists of top flange is 100 by 30 mm. Bottom flange 200 by 40 mm. Web 180 by 20 mm. Find the moment of inertia about an axis passing through the CG parallel and perpendicular to the base. Right, that is IXX. You have to find out IXX and IYY. These are the two things to be found out. Again, we will draw a rough sketch here so that you can understand it. I section will be like this. This is the I section. Generally, it is given unequal section only will be given. This is called the top flange. So that is 100 by 30. This is called the web. This is 180. From here to here, it is 180. And this is given as 180 by 20 mm. And this is bottom flange. This is 200 by 40. So this is 200. This is 40. A rough figure. Again, I section, T section or channel section, they will be symmetrical about one axis. Right. Here, again, you need not find out X bar. X bar, we need not find out. We have to find out only Y bar. Now, this is one reference line. This edge is one reference line. This is another reference line. These two are the reference lines. So we have to find out X bar will be 200 by 2. That is without this thing it will come. Without calculation also we can write it because it will be half of this. Now Y1 that is here, from here to here, that is Y1. I'll take this as 1, this as 2, this as 3. Y1 will be 40 plus 180 plus 30. This is 30 by 2. 135 mm. 135 mm. Y2, that is somewhere here, that is 40 plus 180 by 2, that is 90. That will be 90 plus 40. Oh, this is 235. This is 235. This is 90 plus 40, 130 mm. Y3 is here, this distance. That will be 40 divided by 2. That is 20 mm. Now, A1, this is A1. A1 is 100 into 30, 3000 square mm. A2 is 180 into 20, that is 3600 mm square, and A3 is 200 into 40, that is 8000 square mm. Now Y bar will be equal to A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 plus A3 Y3 divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3. So A1 3000 into Y1 235 plus A2 3600 plus into 3600 into 130 plus A3 8000 into 20 divided by 3000 plus 3600 plus 8000. 14,600 it will be. Now, first numerator, 3000 into 235 plus 3600 into 130 plus 8000 into 20. Whole thing equals divided by, this is 6600, 14600, 14600 will give me 91.3 mm. It is somewhere here. This is Y bar 91.3 mm. All right, so this is Y bar. Now we have to find moment of inertia about axis passing through center of gravity. This is the center of gravity. Parallel and perpendicular, parallel to the base and perpendicular to the base. That means we have to find both Ixx and Iyy as we did in the previous problem. We have to do it here. Now to do Ixx, same procedure is to be followed. Ixx is equal to b1 d1 cube. Whenever you are taking xx, it will be b1 d1 cube by 12 plus b1 d1 into, this is y1 minus y bar the whole square plus B2 D2 cube divided by 12 plus B2 D2 into Y2 minus Y bar the whole square plus B3 D3 cube divided by 12 plus B3 D3 into Y bar minus Y3 the whole square. This is the formula. Now B1 100 into, B1 is 100, D1 30 cube divided by 12 plus 100 into 30 into Y1 is 235 minus 91.3 the whole square plus B2 is 20, D2 180 cube divided by 12 plus B2 D2 20 into 180 into Y2 130 minus 91.3 the whole square plus B3 200 into 40 cube divided by 12 plus 200 into 40 into Y bar 91.3 minus 20. Y3 is 20 square. So now simplify that with a calculator slowly. No hurry, you have to do it slowly. 235 minus 91.3 equals, first do this, square it. Answer square into 3000 plus 30 to the power of 3 into 100 divided by 12 equals engineering 62.17 into 10 to the power of 6 plus this one 130 minus 91.3 equals 38.7 square into 3600 20 into 180 into plus 180 cube t to the power of 3 into 20 divided by 12 will give you this much. Engineering, if you put 15.11 into 10 to the power of 6 plus 91.3 minus 20 equals 71.3 square into 8000 this one plus 40 to the power of 3 into 200 divided by 12. That will give me this much. Engineering 41.7 into 10 to the power of 6. So 62.17 plus 15.11 plus 41.7 will give me 118.98. I can take it as 119 into 10 to the power of 6 mm to the power of 4. This is IXX. Okay, we also have to find out IYY. IYY is easy here. IYY is easy here because no shifting is necessary here, no transferring is necessary, because center of gravity of this rectangle and the center of gravity of the entire lamina is on the same line. So IYY will be just D1B1 cube divided by 12 plus D2B2 cube divided by 12 plus D3B3 cube divided by 12. That's it. Even if you try to shift it, x bar minus x1 will be 0, x2 x bar minus x2 will be 0, x bar minus x3 also will be 0. So there is no necessity to do it. D1, depth 1, 30 into B1 cube, 100 cube divided by 12 plus D2, 180 into B2, 20 cube divided by 12 plus D3, 40 into B3, 200 cube divided by 12. That's it. Take your calculator and calculate it. 30 into 100 cube, 100 to the power of 3 divided by 12. This will give you 2.5 into 10 to the power of 6 into 10 to the power of 6 plus 180 into 20 cube divided by 12. 0.12 into 10 to the power of 6, 0.12 into 10 to the power of 6 plus 200 cube into 40 divided by 12. This will be engineering 26.67 into 10 to the power of 6. The total of all this 2.5 plus 0.12 plus 26.67 will give you 29.29. You can take it as 29.3 into 10 to the power of 6 mm to the power of 4. This is IYY, that is IXX. So this finishes the problem. We have done, I have done all the four sections, the one problem in each section, that is angle section, T section, I section, as well as channel section. Now, if you can do some more, these are the four which are given in your syllabus, very clearly these four sections. So, one of them will be appearing, you will have to do it like this. I hope you have done it. We have done it.